Hey, Entre Nation, Jeff Lerner here, and today we are talking about the best ways to seek out a mentor. As the saying goes, when the student is ready, the teacher appears. Well, this is true for mentorship, but there's literally billions of options out there. And a bit like dating, your job is to figure out which mentor is right for you. If you're new to this channel, do me a favor, go ahead and hit subscribe. And you might say, well, why should I subscribe? Am I a fit for this channel in my precious list of channels that I subscribe to? Well, let me tell you what this channel is about. If you want to have an awesome life and you are interested in ways to pay for it or to build yourself into a successful person who can comfortably go out and create this awesome life, then this channel is for you. If you want to have a crappy life, then this channel is not for you. Or honestly, if you already have so much awesomeness and success, maybe you're a billionaire, I would suggest just not watching YouTube videos at all. Go hang out on your yacht or, you know, play golf at Pebble Beach or whatever. But anyone in the middle, pretty big group, right? This could be a great channel for you. I invite you to subscribe. I post videos a few times a week and just stay tuned. And we're gonna talk through specific steps on finding a mentor. So the first thing to know is that a mentor is somebody that inspires and uplifts you. Now the traditional model states, a mentor is a person experienced in a particular field or business who shares the benefits of that experience with a younger person who is up and coming, called a mentee. At that point, that means that we can put you in a bottle of Coke and shake you up and you'll explode all over the place. That was a really bad joke. I apologize, but that would actually mean you're a mento. Moving on, this isn't actually, I would say, the true definition nowadays, because the way information is dispersed through the digital economy, and so many people are, you know, doing side hustles, and they're not necessarily skilled or experts at a thing, but they're willing to collaborate and learn more about a thing. I think the definition of mentorship has sort of broadened into being anyone who's willing to work with you to improve your life or your skills or your knowledge. They could be younger than you, they could be older than you, they could be an expert at something, or they could just be learning that thing. They could be a stranger maybe whose books you read, or it could be somebody you know who works with you directly. The idea though is that their relationship is something that inspires you and helps you grow to be better at whatever your passions and your goals are. So how do we find such a person? Have you considered even just looking around to your friends, your current friendship circle, as a starting place? How many of your peers would be willing to offer guidance? Or maybe it's somebody you're already working with, somebody at your job, or somebody in your profession who already knows something and would be willing to work with you. That's a good starting point, but you may find that if you're really ready to make a huge change in your life, it might actually mean changing the people that you hang out with. I can say in my experience, working with hundreds and hundreds of people directly and selling training and supporting and observing thousands of people, tens of thousands of people, actually over 150,000 people now in my entire career, a lot of times the big variable in success is actually to change the people that they hang out with. And that's where, frankly, quality mentorship actually can come into play, where as you start seeking somebody who is inspiring to you to guide you on your journey, you start having to change your sphere and change your environment and intentionally push yourself to get around different people. So the first thing you want to do when you're considering such a thing is be really specific. With any big change, you have to get really clear on the final outcome that you ultimately want. And like I said, finding a perfect mentor is a bit like dating. And if you ever hire a dating coach or read about, you know, relationships, that one of the biggest keys to successful dating is fishing in the right pond, right? If you're dating all the wrong ones that don't match your long-term values, or are even worse, are bringing you down, then you're probably not going to get, you know, married successfully and have a great happy life with whoever you're dating. Ditto with mentorship. You need to get specific about what you're looking to learn on a personal and professional level, and make sure that you're getting around people that are congruent with that. And ask yourself, what are your goals a year from now? What are your goals 10 years from now? And really ask yourself and be really concrete and specific about how you answer. And if you're saying, well, I don't actually know, which what I found in my coaching work is that so many people really don't actually know what their goals are when you try to get them to pin down. They kind of have these vague emotional goals, like I want to be happy. That's not a target you can aim for, right? Try and write something down. And if you're struggling, try and write something down anyway. And you can start with an outline to kind of organize your thoughts. You know, what industry are you in? What skills would you like to know more about to either grow in that industry or to get into the industry that you want? How much money do you want to make each year? How much money do you want to make each month? How much money does that mean you have to make each week or even each day? Maybe you don't know the exact, you know, way that it's going to happen, but the process of writing it down is going to force you to start to organize and focus your thoughts to get to things that are specific enough that you can anchor them in so you can really go after them. Step number two in finding a mentor is to play the field. Again, we're using some dating analogies. And I know we talked about finding all the wrong ones, but frankly, playing the field, at least sampling, seeing what's out there, seeing who's out there, could also lead you into the right places. There are so many places that you can gather ideas from until you narrow them down to the exact type of mentorship, the exact type of person that's right for you, and actually finding, you know, someone who's willing to participate in that relationship at whatever level that you need. Frankly, there have been periods of my life when I didn't have a direct personal mentor. My mentors were authors. My mentors were speakers. My mentors were content creators. That's fine, but getting really clear at any given time on who it is that's helping you grow and who it is that you're learning from. Now, to start with, books and podcasts are actually a really good place to start. Read as many books as you can on whatever industry or subject that you're looking to grow in. Listen to podcasts. A lot of times people that write great books also have podcasts, and there's also just some great podcast hosts out there. The key is to get a feel for what you like and what you don't like. And again, that clarity is a great stepping stone to figuring out what's good for you, who's good for you, and plus you're gonna learn a lot of new stuff along the way. How about YouTube right here? You're here listening to this video to get more clarity on finding a perfect mentor. Well, there are actually a lot of great YouTubers, and one of the commonalities between YouTubers, particularly in the personal or professional education or personal or professional development space, is they have a passion for mentoring others or ultimately pointing you in the right direction. And by no means am I suggesting that I should be your mentor, but that is definitely one of the big reasons I do this channel. I get so many people. I got an email this morning from a 10-year-old, and by no means am I targeting kids, but I know that there are a lot of people watching my stuff who may not even have a business yet. They may not even be legally able to start a business yet, but they're learning and they're creating that vision for your life. And I like to think that my content is a part of that growth process for them. Another great place to look is webinars. What I found is, you know, I kind of take these things for granted because it's the world I live in, but there's actually a lot of people don't even know what a webinar is. It's a combination of the word web and seminar. So it's basically a web-based seminar. It's an online presentation to a lot of people, kind of like speaking on a stage, only it's virtual. And people are like, well, how do I find a webinar? Honestly, a lot of the ads that you see on, let's say, Facebook or right here on YouTube that pop up, if you actually click the ad and follow it through, you're gonna very often end up on a webinar or some kind of a video presentation. It may not be something that you register for and actually attend. It may just be something that plays right away. But either way, that's basically a webinar. Have you ever actually tried getting on webinars? Usually good webinars, like bad webinars, will just try to sell you something and that's all there is. Really good webinars teach and train, and effectively they mentor whoever's watching. And maybe even if they sell something at the end, if it's a good webinar, you're gonna get a ton of value. And I think it's really useful to listen and learn from webinars because, again, it helps you get more clarity on, you know, the subject matter and also the person delivering it. It'll help you figure out if that person has something that you're looking for or if that training that's being offered will actually add value to your life. Personally, I've gotten some of the greatest mentorship and the greatest education in my life from actually watching webinars. But I can definitely say I've learned a lot more in terms of what's relevant to the life that I lead and the life that I want to have. I've learned a lot more from watching webinars and following through on training that was offered on webinars than I ever learned in school. And step number three is actually going out and finding a mentor. So assuming that you're now clear on your goals and you're clear on the type of person that you want to work with, the next step is to actually find the right mentor for you. And there's a lot of places that you can go. The first is, And I love this because I've learned so much from these in my life. So much of the life that I have and the life that I want is actually driven by what I've learned through online courses. And frankly, any kind of course, but I like online courses because I don't want to have to like get dressed and go to school. The first place to find online courses is to watch webinars, which are online presentations that generally sell courses. And again, the reason I like these online courses is because in the world today, it just makes sense to learn at your own pace, find a person who not just has the right information that you want, but who's, you know, that you like, that's basically someone you like and you trust and you feel, you know, like they're the right fit for you. Watch their webinar, get into their course. You might have to spend some money, but go through it. It's again, the life that I have is mostly built on stuff that I learned going through online courses delivered by online trainers outside of the traditional education system. So, you know, and I'm not advocating, and I realize I sell digital courses, so it's an easy thing for me to say you should buy digital courses. I'm not saying you should buy them from me, although I'm not opposed to that. I'm just saying that I find that the ability to learn at your own pace and get consolidated information that's not, you know, stretched out into semester-long or annual structures and delivered through this sort of formal establishment education, it's just such a better way to learn. And plus, that way, you know, you're not having to be limited to one course, you're not having to be limited to one major, you're not having to be limited to one professor. For example, when I wanted to start a YouTube channel, I got courses on it, I got training on it. And I'm doing, you know, although I'm just sort of trying to wing it, and not wing it, but like be myself and be authentic and deliver great content, I'm also doing so under a structure, under, you know, to some degree a formula that I learned from watching multiple courses on how to launch a successful YouTube channel. And the key is with that, I didn't just get it from one person. I'm able to get it, you know, I've probably been through four. Yeah, I can think of four. Maybe I've been through more. Different courses on how to do what I'm doing because I wanted to do it well and I wanted to come out of the gate strong. And the best way to do that, one of the nice things is the people who put these courses together are also people who have done the thing very successfully. If I want to go build a $5 or $10 million business, let's say, you know, not to get off track, but I believe in the world that we live in, you're not really secure unless you have at least $5, arguably $10 million. Like having $1 million in the world we live in doesn't actually make you secure. If you have $1 million and your kid gets in a wreck and kills somebody and you get sued by the other family and they sue you for $3 million and your insurance policy only covers $1 million in liability, like it'll wipe you out if you just have $1 million, right? In the world we live in, to be really, really secure, you gotta have $5 or $10 million. So let's say you wanna go learn how to make $5 or $10 million. You're probably not gonna be able to learn that from a college professor, not the real stuff. But on the internet, you can definitely go learn how to do it. There's a lot of people who've done those kinds of things who turn around and teach what they know through courses. And by the way, when you go through someone's course, you're not just getting the information, you're able to learn sort of the qualitative aspects of who they are, how they communicate, how they conduct themselves, their energy, their, you know, vibration, if you want to get kind of metaphysical. And you can find people that really, really resonate with you and go learn from them. And usually when you find online course creators who've gotten the result that you want to get, they actually offer some way to you know, elevate the relationship into a more personal relationship where you actually can get direct mentorship. And I'm not saying they all do that, but a lot of them do. And another really valuable resource are actually live conferences. Attending a live event can be a completely life-changing experience. You not only get up close with people that you might like to mentor you, but you also can make friends with people who are on a similar journey as you and that ultimately will act as support and reinforcement and encouragement and validation for you and you for them. I can tell you, my life completely changed in March of 2009. You know, I got on the internet and started trying to do online business and create this life for myself in late November 2008. And I kind of stumbled along and did just okay. Frankly, I was barely hanging on. But in March of 2009, I went to a live event and everything changed. Coming out of that event, I started making great money. And I'm not saying it was easy or that something magical happened. I'm just saying like I got a different level of information and a different level of conviction and confidence about what I was doing because of the people that I was immersed with at that event. Since then, I have invested, probably six figures going to conferences. I mean, just a month ago, I was at an event. Maybe it's been 2 months. It was right before the whole COVID crisis started happening. Even if you're seeing this years from now, I'm sure you remember the COVID crisis. It was like a week before that all happened. I went to an event in Maryland for 3 days. It was a $5,000 ticket to surround myself by 100 people, with 100 people that between them had generated $1.6 billion in sales through these things I talked about called webinars. I paid $5,000 to just go be in that room for 3 days because of what I knew it would do for me. And there's really just no way to do that outside of going to these events. But these events happen all over the place, all over the world. Every single weekend, there's some amazing event that you could go to get around people who are on a more similar journey and who have achieved more of the results that you want to achieve than probably anyone else in your day-to-day life. And the next thing you can do is become part of a mastermind. Masterminds are usually hosted by one mentor with a small focused group of people, but ultimately everyone in the mastermind contributes and adds value. So you're able to receive value in a mastermind, not just from the kind of the lead mentor or the host, but everyone in the group. It is such a powerful option to work in a close inner circle of people. And usually masterminds are ongoing programs. And that means you can be guided really as an entire group and individually, weekly, monthly, as long as you need. I actually run a mastermind inside my company, Entre. It's an annual program, but people come back year after year after year. It never has to end. And I personally am a part of not only my own mastermind, but another mastermind that I honestly just don't think I could sustain what I do without it. And there's something essential about having a group of people that even just beyond a community, a mastermind, there's an intimacy and there's a collective wisdom that forms as you absorb the knowledge of everyone in the group. Now, if you're maybe not ready to go as far as a mastermind, you could join a membership site. There's lots of membership programs. They're kind of like private Facebook groups. And there's usually, one or two people, kind of figureheads that lead the group, but all the members participate, all the members contribute. My company, Entre, we have a membership program. We also have a free Facebook group, which I'll mention, but you can join these groups and there's really valuable tools because they offer a place to connect with other like-minded people. But they're not usually as expensive or as involved as either a mastermind or finding a one-on-one coach. But here's the thing about memberships. When you're in these groups, you know that everyone in the group is serious. That's one of the biggest differentiators between that and just like a pure Facebook group. And you know they're serious because they're spending money. If it's a paid membership, and that's kind of what I'm talking about, paid membership groups, everybody's taking their growth seriously because everybody's investing some amount of money to be in the group. That's usually a great way to level up the information and the support that you're getting from the group is to be in a group where everybody's spending at least a little bit of money to be a part of it. But even, let's call it a level below that, just a free Facebook group. And again, I have one called Entre Nation. You're welcome to join it. We'd love to have you. But whether it's a free group or a paid group, they can be tremendous places to find that mentor. And a lot of times it's as simple as just making a post, asking a question that defines what you want. Let's say you're in even our Entre Nation free Facebook group, and you just make a post that says, I'm doing XYZ, I've got a thing, I sold a product, whatever, but I really want to learn how to scale up my business. Anyone have any ideas? Usually these conversations will ensue, and what you can do is you can read through the comments and find out who's got the most informed answer, who seems to really, really know their stuff. Maybe direct message that person, see what they do, try to learn more about them, and see if they offer any kind of mentorship, right? Or if there's any way that you can collaborate. I know from experience that when you ask good questions, so many people reply and a lot of great relationships are formed. And a lot of times I can't necessarily see the relationships that are formed in the group because I might even see somebody say like, hey, I'll direct message you or let's take it to a DM. And then I know that there's these great relationships blossoming, and that's one of my favorite things about running the group. Now, I mentioned one-on-one coaching. You could definitely look into getting a personal coach. Obviously, if you're willing to pay for a mentor, a coach is a great option. When I got started in my business, I mentioned March 2009, right around that same time, I took money that I barely had and I hired a coach. And that was another huge part. I mean, really in March of 2009, I did two things. I went to that event at the end of the month, in the middle of the month, right before the event, I hired a coach. And I was able to come back from the event with the confidence, and the inspiration and the early stage of a plan that I got from the event. And then I was able to sit down with my coach, clarify my plan, create accountability for my plan, and just honestly rocket launch. I mean, I can tell you this, from there in March, I had been struggling. I'd been barely breaking even in my business. April was a growth month. I did over five figures net profit in April. May, I did almost $40,000 in net profit. June, I did a little over $70,000 in net profit. And you know, for my life at that time, I was starting out almost $500,000 in debt. It was the first time I felt like, man, I could actually do this. I could actually pull my life out of the ditch. I could actually create what I want in this world. And it was that combination of a live event and a coach that did it for me. I'm not saying that has to be everyone's formula, but for me, they were invaluable. And I don't think I would be here without those two things. And then step number four is to take action. Once you have a mentor, whether it's somebody you work with directly or just somebody whose book you read, take action. Mentors do what they do to impact others and to see their wisdom live on, to whatever they've learned, they want to pay it forward. And so nothing, and I say this as somebody who, you know, I mentor people directly, I try to mentor, you know, through all the content I create. Nothing is more disheartening than when people ask for advice or they just receive advice because they watch your stuff, and then they don't take the action. And honestly, not to like go off on a big tangent here, but there's an epidemic on the internet especially of people just consuming advice and consuming information and watching video after video and reading blog after blog and just like learning and never converting that into any proactive action. Honestly, I would rather somebody just be total ignorance on fire and trying to take action here, take action there, accomplish this, do that, and fail left and right, but they're failing through doing and not ever learn anything. Granted, that's an extreme, because usually that kind of person is also going to be proactively seeking better information. But I would actually, if I was picking someone to work with, I would rather work with the person who is addicted to action taking and almost too busy to even learn than the person who is addicted to learning and so busy learning that they're never taking action. I would much rather work with the first person. And frankly, I try to be more like the first person. I try to make learning something that I fit into the cracks of my action taking. Whereas think about it and look at yourself in the mirror. Are you maybe someone who takes little bits of action and shoves it into the cracks of your learning? Again, I'm gonna suggest you flip that paradigm. A mentor is giving you their most valuable possessions, their wisdom, and in many cases, their time. And the last thing they want to see is somebody that just consumes and never converts it into action. If you're not willing to implement, why would they ever spend time with you? And look, if you don't agree with the advice, find a new mentor or look within and ask yourself why you're resisting. Anyway, so that's what I have to share about finding a mentor. I hope that you found this video inspiring. Let me know below, if you would, in the comments, if this was helpful to you, if you have a mentor, if you've sought a mentor. And also I mentioned my company Entra. We do offer these types of services, these types of, we have online courses, we have a free group, we have a paid group, we have coaching, we have a mastermind, all kinds of things we can do to help, you know, whether you get it from us or you get it from someone else. You know, I know from experience that the hardest thing about being, one of the hardest things, maybe the hardest thing about being an entrepreneur, if that's the track you're on or trying to create your own life or forge your own destiny, is the feeling of being alone, right? We live in a world that's always trying to put us on this track to like be part of the collective, be part of the group, get plugged into the corporation or the school or kind of march down the beaten path, right? And as soon as you want to deviate from that at all, the first thing that you realize, the dynamic changes to where suddenly you're on your own, right? You're kind of like, almost because you're not taking the mainstream advice, it almost feels like you've been rejected by the mainstream. And the intent with Entra is at all levels to make it, to lessen that feeling, right? To support you, to connect you. And that's not the only thing we do, but that's a big part of what we do. But whether it's us or someone else, don't make the mistake of trying to go it alone. That's the number one thing I see that, well, actually it's probably the number two thing I see that kind of undermines entrepreneurs. The number one thing is just the lack of action taking, right? The number two thing is the feeling of being so alone. So anyway, I hope that, like I said, that's been helpful. If it has been, subscribe to my channel. Give me a like on this video. That kind of tells the algorithm on YouTube that this is a good video and they'll show it to more people. In any case, I appreciate your time. Thanks for visiting my channel, and I will look forward to seeing you on the next video. Take care.